Hi friends, my name is Ankur Jain and welcome back to TechSupper channel. Today in this video, we are going to cover our important functionality of web application. So in a web application, there are certain requirements where we need to give a functionality like export to Excel, export data of a table into Excel. So we have to give a button on top of the table which allow me to export all data of a particular table. So here in the VBCS also we have one component which can add this functionality. So here let's see how we can achieve the same into the VBCS. So basically in this video we are going to extend my previous application called employee application, which is created in my previous video, which is accessible over there. And then actually, when we look at the component palette of the VBCS, there is no default component as a export data component. So we have to install this component first of all from the VBCS application only, then only we can use this feature. Once it is installed, then it will be available in the component palette, and then we can use this export data component on a web page and we can drag and drop. Once it is dropped over the page, a button will be there. Then with this button, we can actually associate the data source which contains the data which we wanted to export. So let's see how we can do this in the VBCS. So let's jump in into the VBCS Visual Builder Cloud. So here you see I have this web application called employee application, and on this page we have a table which contains a column first name, last name, email address, and the age. So I want a button over here. By clicking on this button, I wanted to export data of this particular table. Now, as I mentioned in my PPT, that this button does not exist by default into the component palette. Here you see there is no button. So now just go to this, expand this, and here there's a components. So this component section allows us to install the extra component which I wanted to use in my application. So just click on this export data. So this is the component which actually allow me to export a table data into a CSV kind of file. Now just click on the installed component. So once it is installed, this button will be converted into the uninstall component, which means the component has been installed successfully. And here you see the icon is, the caption has been changed and installed, which means this export data component has been installed and ready to use in my VBCS application. So once it is installed, you can only use this component in a particular application. So let's see how we can use this. Just click on this web application, go to this main start page. Now just go to this component palette, and here you see under this extra component, the export data component has been added. Now just drop it here and a button will be created there. Now you see the button has been there. Now you can change the caption as per your choice. You can say export to Excel. Okay, now the caption has been changed. Now just click on this export to Excel button and just click on this data. From here you can associate the data source. So my data source is employee list STP. Okay, now here just now you need to add the columns which you want it to export. So here in the data you need to click on the plus button. So here, once you click on a plus button, you need to give the field name, the unique ID of this column, and the column ID is first name, and then header text you can give like first name, and then you can say the data type will be string type. That's optional. And then you can add another attribute. You can say last name and then field name is the last name. You can add another attribute as a email address, and the field name is email. So basically these fields are taken from this particular table. You can see the code, and then you see the field age, field email, and the field is last name and the first name of this particular table. Okay, now just run your application and just click on this export to Excel, which will export a CSV file and will have column first name, last name, and the email address. If you want age also, then you can add another column just by clicking on this plus and then age, and then from here you can see what is the field name, is the age, and here you can say age. Okay, now just run your application. Okay, now your application has been executed. Just click on export to Excel. Now you see our .csv file has been exported. Now just open this file. Now here you see all the columns like first name, last name, email address, and the age has been exported and corresponding data. So this is how you can make this functionality available. By default name is export.csv, but you can change the file name as well. How? Now just click on this export to Excel component again, and there's a property file name. You can say employee data.csv. Now just run your application again. Now just click on this export to Excel, and here you see file name is employee data.csv. So this is how you can add the export functionality on your web application in the VPCS. Guys, I hope you like the video. If you like the video, please like, comment, and share, and please 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 subscribe my channel in order to get latest video daily in your inbox. Thank you for watching the video. Have a good day. Bye bye.